G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And this is part 8 on the series on calculating wall bracing. And this time we're going to look at the rule in the timber framing code on distribution and spacing. So we've already worked out the sheets that we need, but there's a couple of little things we have to look at as well. So distribution and spacing. Bracing shall be approximately distributed and shall be provided in both directions. Bracing shall be initially placed on external walls and where possible at the corner of the building. Okay, so as far as distribution goes, for wind direction one, we had four sheets that we needed, which is great. So four corners, and we just happened to have walls that work for us. So we can put those four sheets on the four corners and they're going to fit. So they're well distributed. Okay, for ceiling, for wind direction two, we had two sheets. And remembering, I worked out my bracing on 1.2 meter sheets, so we have to fit a 1.2 meter sheet somewhere along this wall. So it's going to fit on this wall in the corner pretty well, but this wall not so much. A 1.2 meter sheet won't fit in this corner, won't fit in this corner, so we're just going to have to put it along the wall somewhere. So in this case, I'm going to put it here. Could quite easily have put it here. Doesn't matter, but I can't get it in the corners. Okay, so that's the initial sheets that I worked out. So the other rule that's going to affect us is spacing. So the maximum distance between braced walls shall not exceed 9 meters for wind classifications up to N2. And for wind classifications greater than N2, we use table 8.20 for N3 classifications. Or table 8.21 for N4 classifications. All right, and then for a lower story of two-story construction or other systems, we use clause 8.3.5.9. Okay, but that doesn't worry me. I'm going to use table 8.20 for N3. So here's the table. Here's our specs on our building. The first thing we need to know is the pitch of our roof, which is 30 degrees. So we're going to use this column here. Now, the next little trick, if you like, is this column here asks for the ceiling depth. So the ceiling depth in comparison to the wind direction. Okay, so for wind direction one, all right, the ceiling depth pushing or resisting that is 8 meters. So it's the width of the building. Alright, does get a little bit confusing. So, the spacing that I need will be 6.7 metres. So, I will have to have a bracing panel every 6.7 metres along wind direction 1. For wind direction 2, alright, my ceiling depth is effectively 14.8. Okay, so we could use 15, or thinking about it now, you're probably better off using 14, go a little bit under. Okay, so we'd say our spacing is 8.4. It could even be 8.3. It's not going to matter because our building's not even that wide. So it's not going to affect anything, but I would probably err on the side of caution and use the 8.3. Okay, so we know wind direction 2, we have to space our bracing units every 8.4 metres. Wind direction 1, we have to space them every 6.7 metres. So if I come back to my plan and look at wind direction 1, and we need sheets every 6.7 metres, so this room here is 6.45 metres, and then you've got more than 6 metres back to this side. So we're going to have an extra two sheets or two bracing units in this wall, okay, resisting this wind direction. So I'm going to put one there, and I'm going to put one there. Okay, now they're on internal walls. That's going to be a pain because we're going to have to then pack one side of all those walls. Unfortunately, in this place, I don't have any built-in wardrobes or anything that I could put them in the back of. That would be the better option, okay, but we need to have two extra sheets resisting the wind in that direction, okay? And for wind direction 2, the spacing was 8.4, or we could say 8.3. As I said, the building's only 7.5 metres wide, so we don't need to have any extra sheets acting in this wind in this direction for wind direction 2. Okay, so now we've worked out the sheets we actually need and how many extra sheets we need because of our wind direction, oh, sorry, because of our spacing rule. The next thing we have to look at is how we tie them down to the floor and how we connect the roof to them.
G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.